Exclamation, everybody, and welcome back to Dishonored. And we're gonna have to take on these guys over here, or at least avoid them as they fight amongst each other. Probably. Although they seem to have killed each other off, so I guess we don't have to do too much there then. That was easy. Do I have that 9? Let's go like that. Thank you. And was it 8? Is time. I want. Is 8 the. No, 8 is the. Yeah. Okay. I always get that confused. I always think that's the time stop, but it's not. What is that? Whoa there. Well there, big fella. Don't be looking through here. Okay, let's see if I can get a higher vantage point up here. Perhaps. Like that. Someone wants to get hurt. Okay, very good. Alright. Jeez, came right up to that, right up to the edge there. So we gotta get to the riverfront. There's all these nice, convenient platforms for us to jump around on. All these guys down there. Get over here. Keep my eyes open. See what I do then. Anything up here I should know about? Does not look like it. Just, they keep saying things like they're seeing me, but I know they don't have vision up this high. That is not how this game works. Ooh, there's a... I'll take that, thank you. Piero Spiritual Remedy. Thank you very much. So got that area there. It's kind of where I have to go, although there are some more convenient... is that coins? Yeah, I'll take those too. There's some more convenient rooftops. Whoa. Okay, Dowd. Easy there, big fella. Easy. Oh, wow. I'm glad that worked. Because I did not mean to let go there. Okay. So we can come up here then. Oof. Dowd has got the jumps, let me tell you. I'm all jumped up here. That is probably glass that will break. Although there is a arc pylon down there that I wish to not have in my life, if I can help it. And something over there. Is that something I can pick up? Or is that just part of the... I think that's just texture work. Okay. Let's get on top of this here. Can't go down in there. But I can walk on this, I think. Let's do a quick save before I do that. Just in case. Come down here. And walk up onto here. There we go. Anything over there I should know about? There's some rooftops, but I don't think that's going to help me. And I hear... Oh, it's right there. How about that? How about that noise? Corrupted charm, I'll take that, thank you. Riverfront. This is a... Or won't your mommy let you? This is an interesting little place. Okay. I guess we'll come over here. Over there. And then, let's see. Oh, there's a guy right up there, isn't there? Let's see. 3? Nope. 2? 4? 5? 5, okay. Wait, is it really 5 or is it 1? 5. Is 5 the... Oh, crap. Z. What is five? Is five my... I want my sleeping darts. Which are... Should be five, right? That's the only one on there, I think, is the five one. No, it's not. No, they're changing things on me. Why would you change things on me, game? That should be five. There we go. Yeah, that's right. Alright, so... Whoa. How is that guy seeing me all the way over there? How the hell is that guy seeing me all the way over there? I'm just gonna do... that. And... Oh, nope. Come on. Stick your head out. Damn it, man! Stand still! Oh, he's... I don't know if he's gonna fall if I hit him. Oh, no, he fell. Oh, that's not good. Alright, we're gonna have to... I wasted a lot of ammo, too. Let's try that again. There we go. Alright, take those two guys out. And then this person's coming out here. He's gonna get a little... Oh, he's too far away, isn't he? Or maybe I'm not supposed to hit him. Yeah, I must not be supposed to hit him, I guess. Or he's too far away. Not quite sure. Took those two guys out anyway. These guys are fighting each other. As they tend to do. Alright, so we'll do eight here. And then let's see if I can get over... What the hell's saying? Huh. See if I can get over to there. Come up this place. And... see, is that... I feel like that's not close enough. Oh, there's something right on this light post. Whoa, okay. King Sparrow feathers. Alright, precarious. Now, am I close enough to get over there? I don't think I am. I don't think I am. This is going to be not good. Not good at all. No, not even close. Not even close. Alright, so this is going to be harder than it looks. I wonder... I could drop down there. I mean, I could blink down there. And then blink across. But not without those guys seeing me, I don't think. Well, there's an overhang there that I can get on, and I can get up to that sign, I guess. And then get over there, maybe. Alright, let's do a quick save here, since I took those guys out without anybody really seeing me. I think I took them out without anybody really seeing me. Is there anybody over on this side here? I have a feeling that there's somebody is. Let's see, six? No. Eight, seven. That's what it is. Any people over there? It doesn't look like it. There is a rune up there that would be nice to get. Alright. So, eight it is. Let us drop down here. I've already quick saved, so it shouldn't be that big a deal. Oh, there we go. Okay, I think we're okay on this side for right now. Oh, is there a... Oh, there's guys over there. Well, that's not cool. Is there a... I'm not even sneaking. I should be sneaking. Is there a... thing here? Oh no, there's hatters down there. Oh no, not hatters. I don't want any hatters. There's a guy down there. Though I could possibly get over to that. Can I come around this way and do it?
I admit, I'm stymied. I thought dragging it up out of the mud was the hard part. But I have no idea how to open it. Hammers?
Think so. I think I can come around this way. Ooh, look at this. Looky here. Choke dust. Can't take it. Too full. Okay. This is one way to do it, I guess. Taking the long routes. Let's see. Can I get up on there? What can I do here as far as this is concerned? Where does that put me? Puts me here. Which is better than what I was. Okay. Those guys down there talking to each other. And... oh, this is a door that I can walk in. Oh, and there's a guy on the other side of that door. Is he coming out this way? Of course he is.
Picked up anything good? Blow off, Java.
Or not? Okay. Whoa, now he is. Now he definitely is. Okay. Take you, please. And I'll take your key. And I gotta find a place to put you. Somewhere. Put you on this bed here. Ooh, a safe. And I use the key to unlock the safe. Alright, well that's good. What's in here? Something good, I hope. Rewire tool and a pouch. Alright, well that's good enough, I guess. Anybody else in here? Anybody else? I don't think so. He was talking to somebody, but I guess that was somebody down below.
Just make it quick. Get up. Get up and we'll finish.
Alright, we'll come over here. Eat that jewel box. What is this? Jerome search for Oxrush. Hello, Griff. I hope your business is going well. If you're interested, I have a little business proposal for you. The canal here in Draper's Ward has been dry for some time now. Enough time for the prized Oxrush to take bloom in the mud. None of the ruffians patrolling this area know how special the flower can be, so I have no competition in harvesting them. But none of the alchemists or natural philosophers that use them frequent this district anymore. Perhaps I can send you some bunches of Oxrush to peddle, for commission of course, and I can help you tap into an ammunition market here in Draper's Ward. The gangs have gone into full-scale war, so demand is high. Let me know your thoughts, Jerome. Well, Jerome, you're going to be sleeping on those thoughts for a little while. I don't need those grenades. Well, let's see if I can take all this stuff, though. Process whale oil. Okay. These guys are fighting each other, as they tend to do. Awesome. Less for me to do. Can I need to blink up there, I think. Come this way and go like so. Yeah. All right. I have a rooftop I can get up on top of if I want to, but I really want to go that way. Let's do a quick save since we're relatively safe here. We have that walkway there, which looks rather precarious, but let's see if I can do it. Okay. So far, so good. Ooh, there's a door here, too. Somebody here. I bet there's somebody here.
I can tell so much about a person by their clothes. Yours tell quite a tale.
Okay. Alright, so, yeah, this is why I couldn't shoot this guy, because he's friendly. So talk to him.
Who are you? Are you with her?
With her?
Delilah, are you with her? No, but you don't have any roses.
What can you tell me about Delilah?
I used to make clothing for the Caldwins, you see. I adored them, especially young, precocious Emily.
That's her picture.
She was such a delight.
How did you get that?
Did you ever meet the Empress? She was so special. And I was able to count her among my friends. I had a lock of hair from young Emily, a keepsake given to me by the family when my hands grew too stiff and clumsy to work the needle. I have treasured it so.
And Delilah?
She visited me here. Such a surprise to see her.
all grown up, so serious. Did you know she was once a playmate of Jessamine's?
Oh, yeah?
Before she was Empress, when they were both little.
I thought it was while she was Empress.
A cordial visit at first, but it turned frightening.
What happened?
She made things come out of the shadows.
No, she's a witch.
Grasping. I can still feel the cold on my neck. I sound mad, don't I? Perhaps I am. She questioned me and left me propped in the corner like a bolt of cloth. I couldn't move for 3 nights while she made the horrid markings you see now.
And there's the rune.
She stole my only keepsake. My lock of hair from dear, sweet Emily.
She's on Emily's trail, too, apparently.
Emily, where are you? Damn that Corvo. And damn Delilah.
So does Dowd stop Delilah from stealing Emily or killing Emily? So then Corvo is able to rescue her?
We won't make it.
That's really cool. I'm going to take this so it stops making noise. That's all your food. I don't need that, so I'll leave you that food. Ooh, cigarette case I will take, though. I need stuff to pawn. What is this? A note from Lady Boyle. My dearest friend, my costume ball will require 3 tailored outfits that are perfectly matching, except for color. We're going to play a game with our guests, you see. I am saddened to hear of your deteriorating hands and the hard times on which you have fallen, as you were my first choice to craft these costumes. I will mention your physical difficulties to my doctor at the party. Perhaps he can be of some service to you. Farewell, Waverly Boyle. Yes, and farewell to you, Waverly Boyle. Corvo's about to lean in on you. Look at that, like a little doll of, is that Emily?
How did it pass me by? All the others down with the sickness.
Cool. This is really interesting. This is a nice little a little surprise as far as the story goes. Okay. It's very cool. Ties into the main story quite well. Okay, I'm gonna go that way, apparently it looks like.
How did it pass me by?
So let's do another quick save. And let's come over here and do this. And then we just gotta drop down there when nobody's looking.
We got company.
Hopefully. Let's do it now and see what happens. There we go. Alright. Go to the riverfront. Ooh, she's got lots of weird hair earrings. The dead eels. With Lizzie's stride free, you have the captain take up river, blah, blah, blah. I think I've read this already. Okay. Oh, we got guys like right here. Eliminate the dead eel mutineer Edgar Wakefield. Okay. There's a sunken crate. Let's not stand here for too long in case those guys turn around. Let's get up on top of this wall.
Man, but he's not as fun as Lizzie. Lizzie enjoyed it.
Yeah, even Lizzie never drowned victims in a sack. I can still see him squirming for air.
Yeah, how's he gonna top that?
Oh, he's gotta top it? They're having a competition on torture methods? Is that what it is? Okay. Well, that's interesting.
Edgar Wakefield is on board the Undine. He's put all of the eels on alert since Lizzie's rumored to have escaped from Coldridge. He's expecting her. You will undoubtedly be a surprise to him.
Dude, you do that again and I'm gonna have to put a bell on you. All of a sudden, a guy in my face. I'm like, what? excerpt from a book on noteworthy intellectual figures. The halls of Academy of Natural Philosophy are thought to be spaces where thoughtful discourse and enlightened tolerance set the tone for debate and learning. It is believed that reason applies above all, and the passions of the greatest minds of the Empire are tempered by wisdom and custom. This is the commonly accepted vision of the place, and is almost always accurate. Almost. Sometimes a protracted debate or disagreement can explode into conflict, and very rarely, violence. Such was the case years ago in the month of winds. A young apprentice named Piero Joplin ventured into strange new directions of research in the preservation of mortifying tissue, a field that brought him into frequent conflict with a student named Trimble. Joplin and Trimble often debated loudly long into the night, and the content of these arguments was well beyond the understanding of most people of the Empire, this author included. The rivalry between the two natural philosophers raged for months, but it is the climax of those events that prompts this writing. The two had argued deep into the night, a debate sliding into bitter personal attacks. At last they reached a terrible accord. Their mutual hatred culminated in a duel to the death with pistols. Under the gray sky of dawn, the greatest minds of the Empire of the Isles gathered in the courtyard in a fashion resembling schoolboys gathering to watch two bullies fight. I think that's supposed to be two bullies. A quiet fell as Joplin and Trimble accepted the ceremonial pistols, marked off the paces, turned, and fired. Each combatant fired round after round, shattering windows, chipping masonry, and splitting plaster. The closest shot to the mark was Joplin's, whose bullet ripped through the hem of Trimble's overcoat. It was clear that the dedicated study of the learned men had made for poor marksmanship. When all their ammunition was expended, both parties stood quivering with fear and rage, but unharmed. It was then agreed that the duel would be settled with a coin flip. The newly minted coin of the Empire was produced, bearing the face of Empress Jessamine Caldwin. As it was sent spinning into the air, Trimble called heads. The coin landed tails. Joplin was declared winner, and the feuding between the men ceased. By the terms of the dispute, Trimble was forced to leave the Academy, his studies left incomplete, whereupon a dignified silence returned to the halls of the Academy of Natural Philosophy. Wow. That was an interesting little tidbit of a story there. Notes from a Hatter spy. Mr. Hat, there has been interesting activity since our raid on the Dead Eels a few days ago. It looks like Wakefield has been rooting out Lizzie loyalists and chasing them off or making an example out of them with some gruesome killing. I don't think he's got much of a hold on this gang, and things are likely to fly apart before long. Also, I swear I saw a woman lurking on some nearby rooftops last night, spying on the eels. She saw me looking at her and just disappeared. Perhaps you'll know what to make of that. Yeah, I know what to make of it, even though the Hatters don't. Ooh, I'll take this Piero thing. Okay, cool. So, nice little convenient window here to jump through.
There's the boat. Wakefield's probably keeping himself below decks. Whatever I do to him, it will be a mercy.
Whoa,
compared
who is
to
that
what
up there?
Has in mind.
Who is that up there? Oh, she just disappeared. Okay. Alright. I know I saw her. She just disappeared there. Let's see if I can get over here.
I can't believe we're missing the boil party. Luxury. To the river. Or canal. Just waiting to be taken.
All those prince and nobles and their families.
Wakefield sealed himself in the cargo hold of the Undine. Smuggling ships like this one often have a hatch underneath for dumping contraband if they get caught. Perhaps the Undine is no different.
So I should take a swim, you say.
I see a man set on fire. What
who's,
is
he? Who's talking?
He jumps in the water.
Who's funny. Who's talking? Okay. So we should probably jump into the water and swim up underneath. Which looks like this pipe will take me right to where I want to be. So we can do that.
That creepy feeling of being watched. I've had that a bunch lately.
Yeah, I know. It's crazy, isn't it?
This feeling of eyes on me. I looked up on the roof of that building over there and...
What the fuck? There was a lady up there, right? I seen her too. Just staring.
Then yep, I saw her too.
In a wink. Yeah. We've seen the same thing.
Sunken crate. Oh, that's the crate that I asked for. I was wondering what the sunken crate was. That's the one that I said, give me a sunken crate full of loot. So perhaps I will go over this way then. And then swim the rest of the way over. Yeah, I wonder if I can get up on that roof there. It's not looking... not looking good. Yeah, it's not looking like I can. But Oh, and he's scratching his crotch. I think I can at least go down into that boat. Although this guy is looking straight that way. Like, he has not moved an inch from there. I could actually just blink over there and grab... Actually, let's do a quick save. I could just blink over there, take him out, or take that other guy that's moving around out. And then this guy probably doesn't have anything. Yeah. I think that is probably a good idea. Because that other guy's not moving at all. Doesn't look like I'm quite making it either. Let's go like this. Grab this guy. And we'll just put him down somewhere. Let's come up here, maybe. Get up on the roof there.
Dowd, this is the second time now. I see something, or someone, out of the corner of my eye. But when I turn, they're gone. Someone is watching us.
Sorry, guy. All I can see out of the corner of my eye is this guy's ass. I think you're just crazy. Okay, so we've done that. And then I hear a whatchamacallit here. Where's that at anyway? Was it 6? No, 7? Yeah, it is in here, isn't it? So I assume there's a way in here. Let's do 8 again so I can get back up on this roof when I need to. And go like this. Grab him. Put him up on here. Oh, that didn't work. Not quite. Yep, that works. Alright, you sit over here, please. And it looks like there's something here to be had. Some feathers. Ooh, okay. Okay. Smaller jumps. Smaller jumps. So how do I get into this place? Obviously there must be a doorway somewhere here. Come around this way. Maybe there's a window to get in or something. Huh. Or a back door, perhaps? No, that's locked off. Let's do another quick save here just in case, because those guys are all looking around over there. There must be a way in there, right? Ooh, hello. Yeah, I want to get up on top there, please. Thank you. Alright, how does one get into this this building here? There must be a latch somewhere. Let's see. 7. It's definitely in here, right? From what it looks like, it definitely is. Unless it's in the water. No, I don't think it's in the water. I think it's in this place. I don't know how I would get in here. Alright, well, it'll just remain a mystery for now, I guess. Let's go get that bone charm there and the sunken crate. Perhaps. So we'll get over to here. Drop down. Watch there be all kinds of crazy stuff in this water. You know there is going to be. They're not going to let me just swim through this. There's going to be some craziness down in here. Yep, there's fish. Yep. Figures. How's this sunken crate at? No. Oh, there it is. It's down here. Hello? Yeah, there we go. ingots, pistols, Piero's remedy, bone charm, that stuff. All right, that's all she wrote there. That's all we can get out of that. Let's get some air. All right, cool. I am sort of moving a little bit here, which is not cool. Let's do another quick save while we're at it. And let's see if we can swim over to the other side a bit without being seen. That would be nice. And yeah, it looks like there is a hatch here. Hopefully I can open it before I run out of air. Come on, get up there, Dad. You can do it. Just barely. All right, let's get up here.
Smaller than I remember.
This is no time to be comparing boat sizes. Let's close this hatch. I'll fall back down there again.
Can't keep their damn prisoners locked up.
All right. Edgar Wakefield log entry. It's going to pieces. I was just getting things under control, but now I hear Lizzie busted out of Coldridge. How? The dead eels are all struggling starting to swing my way, and I even think it will wipe out those accursed hatters soon. Mr. Hat humiliated me something awful with that raid to steal our engine coil, and payback was going to be me taking a piss in his stovepipe. But now that Lizzie is free again, I've got the crew on high alert, orders to kill anyone that ain't one of us. I'm starting to think I'm a bit off more than I can chew. You certainly did, sir. You certainly did. Speaking of biting off things more things than you can chew, where is this guy at that I keep hearing? Oh, he's over here.
Let it come to this. Lizzie's on her.
Okay.
Time to signal Lizzie.
So we've neutralized Edgar. Oh, this is Edgar. Okay. I was wondering. Wondering about that. Came up right on top of Edgar. So what do I do with this guy? What do I do with him? Do I just put him down somewhere? Do I blink him away? What do I do? Signal Lizzie using the ship's horn. Oh, I guess maybe I can just leave him here. Maybe. And then let's get the other guys on this boat. Let's get them all sleeping as well. And then, okay, so there's a guy right there. Let's do a quick save. And let's do 7. I always keep hitting the wrong things. There's a guy walking around up there. And I have to hit the signal ship's horn, okay. Where's this? There's a bone charm down there, 17 meters down under the water. So let's see if I can grab these guys. Oh, there's a lot of people on this deck. Holy hell. Holy hell, there's a lot of people on the deck. Maybe I need to go back where I came, from whence I came, and blink up on top of it, perhaps. Also, there's another bone charm that I could pick up. So that might be a thing as well. Like right over here. There we go. So let's go this way. Go 8. Let's get some air, Dowd. Some air, Dowd. There you go. Okay, where can we go? We gotta sound the ship's horn somehow. Without drawing. Oh, okay, that person just kind of saw me a little bit. Can I get... Oh, we got more of these damn fish here. Let's see, I've got... Whatchamacallit. Got whatchamacallit. I've quick-saved already. So I just need to get... some elevation. Elevation would be nice. Some elevation, maybe? Picked up anything good. Here. And then we'll come over this way. Do that. Okay. Ship engine throttle, huh? I wonder if that would... If I hit the throttle, these guys are all gonna fall, I think. I would think they would. I wonder if that'll work. So they don't come running after me as soon as I hit this... As soon as I hit this horn. Emerald Tea in the fleet. Need that. I'm wondering. Let's do another quick save while I'm here. Although this is probably a bad spot to quick save in. So I'm probably gonna be seen at some point. I wonder, let's do this. Engine failed to start. Damn. Okay. I know that they're just gonna come after me if I come up here and do this, but maybe I can blink over to that rooftop over there once I do this. Let's pull it and run. Or not.
Lizzie Stride is assuming control of the Dead Eels now. She's ordered them to give you safe passage.
Oh, whew. Okay, well that works. Okay.
Your friend Edgar Wakefield set me up to be taken by the City Watch, and you followed him. Took his orders. But you know what? I forgive you. All of you. I'm filled with love. But the following people each owe me a finger. Logan, Douglas, Bang Bang, Ferris, Pigface, the Bakers, and Annabelle.
Shit. Is that everybody?
Two from you, Annabelle. Have a good night.
Lizzie. What are you gonna do with all those fingers? I'll give you a finger.
That piece of garbage, Edgar. I'm still living with his incompetence. He let the Hatters cripple the Undine.
Ship seems fine to me.
They took the engine coil. We're dead in the water.
What is it? Can we make a new one?
They don't make them anymore. Not for an engine like the Undine's. We'll have to get it back.
Of course we will.
The geezer still leads the Hatter gang, right? I'll pay him a visit.
It won't be that easy. There's a snag.
Always is. What's this one?
The geezer's about 100 years old by now. He's got it rigged so that if he dies, the whole place gets gassed. So they're real careful around him. Got him a nurse and everything. Maybe you can cut a deal for that engine coil. Turn on the charm. One of the Hatters
I don't think I'm that charming.
Password in exchange for keeping the rest of his fingers. It's whalebone. I never got to use it on account of the gas and being in jail.
Just be ready to move.